What's up guys, welcome back to my channel. So today's video is going to be on this tangerine makeup look. This video is definitely a chit chat video, so if you're into those, you're gonna like this video. I've been absent and I felt like I should just come back and be like, hey, this is where I was, this is what I was doing. So yeah, that's what this video is. Quick disclaimer, my camera in the middle of filming just broke and then it turned on and then it started like corrupting my SD cards. So basically every time I insert an SD card into my camera, it like just corrupts the SD card and I can no longer access the files on that card. So this is what I had to resort to, filming on my iPhone, and I was just not about to give up, okay? I was just not about to give up. I really wanted to get a video up. I really wanted to film this look. If you guys want to see how I got this makeup look and just want to chit-chat, yeah, because that's a word. Chit-chat. It's chit-chat. If you guys just want to see where I've been and what I've been up to, then just keep on watching this video. This is just proof that it's time I got a new camera, which is something I've been wanting to do, but cameras are expensive, yo, so I just haven't gotten myself to it, you know? I need to like save up or something. So now I'm gonna highlight the face and conceal it with my NARS Radiant Creamy Concealer in Ginger. But before I do that, I'm gonna take Caramel and I'm just gonna spot conceal the areas that need to be spot concealed. My skin's actually doing pretty well. So the other day while I was at home, I managed to do my makeup with just concealer and my skin looked amazing. So if you guys want to see that like makeup tutorial, like a no foundation makeup tutorial, let me know because I would love to do one for you guys. So I actually just wanted to fill you guys in because I have been kind of absent from my channel. And I would say kind of absent in general. I'm just gonna blend the concealer out using my Morphe E8 brush. So I've just been taking some time out. I took a lot of time out, I needed it. I was just going through a lot with school and then going through a lot personally. And just like life in general was just kind of hitting me in the face, and it was hard to like deal with everything at once, and I ended up feeling really uninspired and unmotivated, and yeah, just like I couldn't handle everything, you know. School is getting pretty intense. It's not that easy anymore. It's like I'm capable of the work, it's just that it's a lot of work, and I'm a person who struggles with disciplining myself to like work. Unless I enjoy the work that I'm doing or feeling inspired by it, I struggle to like discipline myself. I do have like classes that I have to take that I don't want to take, and so I sit there and I'm like, what the hell is going on? I don't like this class, I don't like this work. Then I start to like not engage or understand the content well, you know? So that's kind of like what ended up happening as a result of just having to deal with like life and, you know, just all the other things that life will throw at you. But I'm doing a lot better. I have overcome, I still am, and I will continue to like just overcome everything, and I feel a lot better. I don't know if I fully portray my personality in my videos, but I'm generally quite a happy person. So I've definitely returned to my true self. I just want to like fill you guys in a little bit, but I don't want this video to be too long, so I don't know how this is gonna work out. So now I'm gonna bake under the eyes just because this foundation is very creamy, along with the Radiant Creamy Concealer from NARS. So I'm gonna bake. Okay, maybe I'm not baking, I'm also just pressing in the powder. Actually, I'm just gonna bake there. I feel like I need to bake right there. So, I'm sorry if this looks weird, but we're just gonna leave it there for a little bit. I am now taking the love of my life, my, can you see it, my Make Up Forever HD powder, which is almost finished, and I also smashed it, and I'm just going to go under the eyes and on the sides of the nose. I always have to go in with this powder. I don't trust to not go in with this powder. Like, my makeup is incomplete if I don't go in with this powder. Okay, so now we're gonna move on to the eyes. I'm going to go in with my Morphe 3502 palette, this beauty right here. And I wanna do the tangerine makeup look. I've been seeing this everywhere. I think it's the trend for spring, the tangerine. So that's what I'm gonna be doing today. So I'm gonna go in with, I think I'm gonna go in with the shade first. I just wanna take that in the crease, just to kind of define the crease a little. So I'm taking this mostly in the crease, but I am gonna run it all over the eye as well, just to give that tint all over the eyelid. But I mostly wanna define my crease. So what else did I wanna tell you guys? So I went to New York. Oh my gosh, you guys. Actually, thinking about it makes me wanna cry. Like, I don't know if you guys know, but like, New York is like my favorite city ever. It's my favorite place on earth, honestly. Before I came to Boston, my dream was to go to New York and move to New York and live and study in New York. Like, it was something I spoke about from a young age. Like, my mother would tell me, and she still tells me, that like, when you were younger, you just started saying that you want to go to New York and you want to live in New York, and that that was your dream. So I went there with a friend of mine. We just went for the day. We went on Saturday, I believe, and it was just amazing. And it was so crazy. Like, we both got so emotional when, like, as soon as we saw the board, because we drove up there, and as soon as we saw the board, we both got so emotional. Like, we didn't actually start crying, but you could just feel, like, in the space of the car, the emotions, and like, we were like just talking, and we were like, we're actually here, you know. And we've both been there before, but it just felt, it's just such a magical place. I don't even know how to describe it. Like, I don't even know, guys. I don't know. But that's like, that place is like, it holds a special place in my heart. Now I'm gonna go in with this very bright shade right here, and I'm taking it on a pencil brush. So I'm gonna run this along the lash line first and then buff it up, but I'm mostly focusing it along the lash line. So we went there on St. Patrick's Day, and it was really cool because there was the huge St. Patrick's Day parade, which was pretty awesome, and also kind of like chaotic and annoying, because then a lot of the streets were closed, and there were shops that we wanted to go to that we couldn't go to. And then there was like also shops we were able to get to, but it just took so long to get to them because like there was just like kind of gating everywhere, and we couldn't just like walk across the street. We had to like, you know, it was quite the journey to like get to particular shops. But it was still really cool. It was cool to be there. It was just amazing. I already want to go back so bad, because I don't know how to explain it, you guys, but it's just like the most amazing place on earth. I truly believe that. It's truly magical. It makes me happy, and I definitely hope I get to live there at some point in my life. Like, that's my dream. So I'm pretty much just running this along the lash line, then buffing it up, and also kind of creating a wing. I don't know, it's like, I don't want to take it all over the lid. I kind of just want to do this, you know? And I really like this. I think this is really pretty. It's almost like I'm creating winged liner with this. So now I'm going to go in with this brush. I don't know what brush this is. It doesn't have a name. It's probably a paintbrush for all I know. But I just like that it's flat, but at the same time still fluffy and dense. With that brush, I'm just gonna go into this shade, which is a little bit darker, and I'm gonna run that literally on the lash line. Even lower than I took the brighter shade. So, do you guys know BTS? I've been listening to a lot of BTS lately, and I cannot stop. I even saw that there is it the BT21? I'm not sure, but you know they're like the figures. I don't want to say anything wrong because I feel like BTS fans, like the army, is so passionate that if you say anything wrong, they will eat you alive. But I saw their store when I was in New York and it was really cool. I didn't go in, but I drove past there quite a few times. And it was awesome. I feel like if you're not listening to BTS at the moment, you just need to reevaluate your life. They are so talented and so inspiring. I love that when they write music, they write with a purpose. And every song carries a strong message, a particular message, and it's a strong one that everyone can relate to. And it's just amazing. So I've been really into them and feeling very inspired by them. And I will continue to listen to their music. I would definitely say I'm part of the army. Definitely. I'm just gonna take this a little bit higher because I feel like it's a little higher on this side. But yeah, everything about them is awesome, even their fashion. I think that's what drew me to them the most initially. My little sisters, the one time when I went home last year for Christmas, and they were just like, oh my gosh, you need to listen. You need to see these boys and you need to listen to the song. So I was like, okay, cool. And one of my sisters, Sarah, you know, I feel like she knows me pretty well. So I was like, if she thinks I'm gonna like this song and I'm gonna like this boy band, this K-pop band, then, you know, she's right, I definitely am. And they played me Blood, Sweat, Tears first. That's the first BTS video I ever saw. And I was immediately hooked. I was like, okay, I wasn't immediately hooked, but I was like, whoa, beauty. You know, I was like, this is amazing. The fashion, the setup, everything. I was like, this is so amazing. I was just so amazed. And then after that, I believe they played me DNA. And then that was it. And I wasn't like immediately drawn to them, you know. I was like drawn to them visually, but like not through the music, because I was just like, how are you listening to music that you don't understand? You know, at first I was closed-minded like that. So that was like my biggest issue. I was like, you don't even know what they're saying. So how are you listening to the songs, you know? And they were like, they were very offended, and I was like, I get it, you know, I'm not getting it the way you want me to, so it's cool. And like, and then that was kind of the end of like my first BTS experience. I'm just taking some powder and I'm just gonna put it along the wing here because I just feel like I need to clean up the wing a little bit right here. If you ever want to clean up anything and you already have like your foundation and your concealer on, translucent powder is the best. It is your friend. I just want to clean this up and make it a little sharper. I'm just going to go in with a fluffy brush and I'm just going to just blend everything out a little more, and I'm kind of just gonna blend all over the eyelid just to kind of give it that tint of tangerine, but it's not going to be too much because we actually have nothing on this brush. We're just using what's already on the eye. I'm gonna go back in with that first color because I don't want it to go away too much. I think I blended it out too much. So I'm just gonna like add a little more. So that's what I'm gonna do for the eyes. Now I'm just gonna move on to the face. I'm not gonna set my face today just because I don't feel like it, but I am gonna go in with some bronzer. I'm using my Laura Mercier bronzing powder in the shade number 4. Man, I think bronzing is my favorite part of doing makeup. Like, I love bronzer. So as I was saying, that was kind of like the end of my first BTS experience. And then I would say somewhere in the middle of January, I was back here in Boston and I was on Instagram and I saw a video that Vogue had uploaded, because I follow Vogue on Instagram. If you guys follow Vogue on Instagram or YouTube, you will know that they often do videos with different celebrities, either of celebrities getting ready for red carpets or award shows, or they do like the 73 questions, or they show like celebrities doing their own makeup. So I love all those videos, and on their Instagram I saw that they did a video with BTS, and the first thing I just saw was like, oh my gosh, I like the way these guys are dressed. And then I was like, wait a minute, I've seen those faces. I think they were wearing like full, like head to toe Calvin Klein, like the new Calvin Klein collection. And then I immediately, after watching like the little 1 minute video, I went onto the Vogue channel and I watched like the entire video, and I was like, whoa, man, these people are amazing. Like, they look good, they dress good, the music that's playing in the back sounds good. And then after that, I just started watching like their videos on YouTube, videos like DNA, Blood, Sweat, Tears that I had seen before, and then all their other videos, like their music videos. And yeah, and I've basically just been like hooked since then. So I'm gonna go in with my Fenty Beauty highlighter in Mean Money and Hustler Baby. I feel like I haven't used this in a while, but I'm not sure. I'm gonna take some down the nose as well. I'm gonna take some right here above the brow. Okay, now I'm gonna go in with blush. Now that I've applied highlight, just so the blush can kind of blend into the highlight and blend it out, I'm taking my Marc Jacobs 502 Lines and Last Night. It's this beautiful kind of orange, and I'm gonna take it on a fluffy brush, actually the one I was bronzing with, and just apply it. I'm gonna take this Smith 112 brush. And then I'm gonna pop some on the nose as well, just because. On the chin, just because. Okay, now for the under eyes. I'm not gonna go in with the first shade. I'm just gonna go straight in with that second shade that we applied, and I'm gonna put that along the lash line. I know my blog has been dry, and I feel like I always say this, but if you do follow me on my blog, it's been dry. But I'll make a comeback real soon, so stay tuned for that. Stay tuned for that. So I do want to take a little bit of brown for the lower lash line. I'm going to go into this chocolate brown shade right here, and I'm mostly going to focus that on the outer corners. I'm gonna take my face highlight and just put that onto the inner corners. before applying mascara, I'm just gonna set my face with my Morphe Continuous Setting Mist. So I'm first going into my Marc Jacobs Velvet Noir Mascara. Then I'm gonna go in with my Benefit Therreal. This is my favorite mascara ever, but also just my favorite lengthening mascara. Then on the lower lash line, I'm taking my MAC Extended Play Giga Black Lash. Okay, so I'm gonna start off with my MAC Strip Down Lip Liner. And I really kinda wanna buff this in, I don't want it to be defined at all. So I don't know if you guys can tell, but I'm trying to like just buff it in. I haven't used this in so long, so I'm taking Dirty Peach from Kylie Cosmetics. And I'm not going as like far out to the edge of the lips with this, just because it's a little too light, so I feel like it'll look ashy. That's why I applied MAC Strip Down first. Now we're gonna take the Dirty Peach Matte Lip, which I haven't worn in a long time, and I also haven't worn matte in a long time. Let's try some lip gloss. This is my Unreal L'Oreal Lip Gloss. Okay, I think that's better. My lips look really huge right now. So that's it for this video, you guys. I hope that you enjoyed it. I hope that you had fun just catching up and finding out, you know, what I've been up to and stuff like that. I hope this video wasn't too long. It probably was. It probably was. But if you guys did enjoy this video, or if you do at least like this makeup look, definitely give me a thumbs up. Comment down below and let me know, do you guys want me to continue filming on my iPhone? Is it HD enough? You know, is it good? Is the sound good? Or should I just, you know, get a new camera or try to fix my camera? I should probably get a new camera. I know I need a new camera. It's about time. So yeah, give this video a thumbs up. Don't forget to click the notification bell so that you don't miss out on my next upload. And subscribe if you already made it this far. I mean, you might as well. I will see you guys in my next video. Thank you so much for watching. Bye. I look good though, don't I? This makeup look looks really good. Oh damn, was that bag there the whole time? Whatever. I'm sorry.